paper 6-2 alternative to practical February-March 2020. Okay, this is the instruction information, and yeah, now we directly to see this question. Number one, a student is determining the density of wood by two methods. Yeah, he using the wooden rod. Yeah, shown in figure 1.1. Yeah, this is maybe the first method is by measuring. Yeah, measuring volume and mass over volume. And the second is by volume, use the kayak apa namanya, beaker glass ya. Oke, kita cek aja one. Oke, this is the length L, diameter D, loop of thread. Oke, wooden rod. Method 1, the dimension of wooden rod are shown full size in figure 1.2. Oke, this is length, diameter. Measure the length L and diameter of D, the wooden rod, in figure 1.2, L and D in centimeter. Okay, actually this is you need to apa namanya hold the paper ya. Tapi I use this is view as coba actual size. Oh, this is actual size. This is actual size. Yeah, I use ruler. How much centimeter is? Let me check. Let's say our screen is like paper. Yeah, this is around 4.5 centimeter. Yeah. This is 4.5 centimeter. Yeah, 4.5 centimeter. Yeah, that's. And then diameter, again I use this ruler here. Yeah. This is actual size. So this is around 2.0 centimeter. 2.0 centimeter. This is around 2.0 centimeter. Yeah, 2.0. Okay, that's it.
Pak,
yes.
Ini sengaja nggak present screen
atau? Ah, astaga. ya. Bapak lupa kok nggak print screen. Ya ampun. Yes. Oke, okay, sekarang kelihatan nggak?
Iya.
Iya, oke. Okay. Sorry, Bapak lupa.
Iya, Bapak.
Oke. Okay. Ini sir gunakan actual size ya, actual size. This you see, this is actual size ya. So like we hold the paper ya. I use the ruler to see how much length is. This is around 4.5. The length is, and then the diameter is around 2 centimeter. Ya, so 2.0 centimeter. That's it. Okay. Suggest an accurate method for measuring the diameter of wooden rod in this experiment. Is any additional apparatus that might require briefly describe how you would determine the diameter. You may draw a diagram if help applies you answer. This is let's say diagram ya. Ya, kita misalkan gunakan ruler, gambarnya agak susah ya. Misalkan this is ruler and this when we see let's say like this one ya. This is ruler. Ya, mungkin nanti bisa digambarkan di sana, harus pakai tulisan tangan ini maybe ya. This is ruler. Ya, kita diagramnya seperti ini. Ya. And here maybe scale 0. Ya. And so on ya, dan seterusnya ini kita gunakan ruler. And then maybe for it's also apa namanya circle lingkaran ini. Ya, sebutlah kalau kita bisa gunakan vernier caliper ya, or use ruler also can that vernier caliper ya, like this one. Let's say this is vernier caliper ya. Oh ya, Kalista mungkin belum pernah ke sekolah ya, belum pernah lihat vernier caliper ya. Ya, ini untuk menghitung atau measure the diameter like ball or something yang dia nilainya lumayan kecil ya, kayak in 2 cm, 1 cm. Kita lebih bagus pakai vernier caliper. Dia kayak dijepit ya, kemudian ada scale-nya berapa seperti itu. So, this is like where are you going, Dek? Eh, where are you going?
I'm not going anywhere. I'll go this way. Can you take me, mommy?
Which one?
That one. Where's the 10,000?
Don't go far away. Jangan jauh-jauh ya.
Okay.
Sorry. Yes, use ruler. Yeah, use ruler to measure length. Measure length. And also measuring diameter and also can use same vernier caliper to Sorry?
Pak, ini dia cuma suruh measure diameternya kan?
Iya.
Diameter bukan cuma yang kayak circle-nya ini doang.
Iya, diameter. Iya. Oke, oke. Berarti using vernier caliper ya, this one ya.
Iya.
Oke, oke. Berarti using vernier caliper or using by ruler. Berarti ini Bapak ini aja, delete aja. Okay, diameter. Yeah, so maybe yeah, ini kita using by vernier caliper or ruler ya. Kalau kita cek bisa misalkan sini. Ya, tadi kita gunakan misalkan ini adalah ruler. Maka ini adalah scale 0. Ini harus ini scale 0 dan berapa ini scale ini. Nah, let's say ini adalah ruler. Oke, berarti use ruler to measure diameter. And also Ya, seperti itu mungkin ya. Bisa menggunakan penggaris atau bisa menggunakan vernier caliper. Sebenarnya ada satu lagi yaitu menggunakan micrometer screw, tapi itu untuk pengukuran diameter yang lebih kecil lagi ya. We use apa to measure diameter that small apa lebih kecil lagi ya. Oke. Kita lanjut ke seterusnya ya. Oke. Nah, sekarang the student use balance to measure the mass of wooden root as on figure 1.3. Oke, dia menggunakan balance apa atau timbangan yang neraca. Record the mass, berarti ya ini ada jelas-jelas 7.8 gram ya, 7.8 gram. Then, calculate value rho 1 for the density wooden root. Use value from A1B and equation rho A is 4M PD square times L. Yeah, equals suitable. Okay. Okay. This is actually M over mass. Yeah. Kalau kita, sorry. M over volume. Yeah, M over volume. Volume is PR square. Tapi R-nya itu kita ganti dengan d over 2 ya, d over 2 dan square. Oke, kita kalau hitung misalkan kita masukkan in gram centimeter square ya. Rho 1 equals to 4, mass-nya adalah 7.8 gram. And then divided by pi is 3.14 times d square. D is we have d, let's go up, d is 2.0, and then square times l, length is 4.5. Okay. There. Coba kita hitung di kalkulator. Kalkulator di mana ya? Kali itu mengungkap dan divided by kekumpulan this is around 0.55 ya, or in gram centimeter angkat minus 3 ya, or here is 0.55 gram per centimeter 3 ya, that's it. Okay. Kira-kira bisa mengerti ya, Kalista ya? Oke. Ya, kita lanjut lagi. Ya, ini berdasarkan method 1 ya. Nah, kita lihat berikutnya. Nah, ini second method. Ya. The student pours water into measuring cylinder as on figure 1.4. He then floats the wooden rod in the water as on figure 1.5. Okay. This is around 152.468 ya. Yeah. This is I think around 144. Ya. Yeah. in centimeter kubik. Centimeter kubik. And then after the floppy, here is 152. Yes. Sorry. Okay. But this is floating, yeah. Let me check again. Okay. Record the V1 water level measuring. Okay. V1 is here. Yeah. Yeah. 144. Yeah. 144. And then this is 152, yeah, centimeter cubic. Okay, continue ya Kalista ya. Okay, ya. Yeah. Nah, tapi kemudian ini the student remove the root and lowers a base modeling clay into water and so in. Okay, he then hooks the root modeling clay. Okay, yes. Okay, this is 164 here, yeah, and 178, yeah. So calculate another root 2 for the density wooden root use value from C and D and the equation root 2 V2 minus V1 V4 minus V3. Oh, okay. Times K. Oh, yeah. K is, this is actually density of water, ya. Yeah. Okay, kita inikan aja, kurangkan saja. This is equals to V2 minus V3 adalah, kita cek yang tadi ya, 152 144 152 divided by 4 178, yeah, 178 minus V3 is 164, yeah. So equals to, kita check, yeah, times one, yeah, times one, times density of water, yeah. So kita kalkulatorkan lagi, 152 minus 144, yeah, divided by 178 minus 164, ya, 0.57, ya. Okay, root 2 actually this is 0.57 in gram per centimeter cubic also, ya. That's it. Okay. Ya, yeah, that's it. Ini kalau Cambridge enaknya gini ya, kadang we already provide by the equation. Jadi kita tinggal submit apa masukkan substitute number aja. Oke. Okay. Oke, okay, continue ya Kalista ya. Oh, no E. What is that? In figure 1.8, draw an arrow showing correct line sign reading volume of water to measure cylinder. Oh. the correct line set for reading? Oh, bagaimana kita melihat ya kalau misalkan correct line? Ini kalau mata, nah, ini maybe let's say this is our eye. Correct sign is this is like in perpendicular yeah, or right angle yeah, in right angle. This is our eye yeah, ear pen perpendicular. On perpendicular. Ya, karena pertanyaan adalah draw an arrow showing the correct line sight reading the flow of water in missing cylinder. Okay. Suggest possible source in correspondence to if one was carried or carefully. Oh, such as possible source in accurate method. Oh, big, about volume of clay. I think the first one is volume of clay. Yeah, volume of clay. Yeah, and or yeah. You know this about they have a root ya yeah. They have apa tali ini nih. Tali ini juga hook ini dia punya volume ya hook volume oh. Yes hook volume so different ya yeah. Hook volume karena ada penambahan they have include about hook volume or volume of clay is not apa namanya perfectly same thing atau ratio with the previous one it's not like exactly apa namanya tepat gitu ya seperti itu. Pokoknya ini ada like penambahan volume, ya, penambahan volume sehingga nilainya beda. Oke, okay, that's it. Continue, Kalista. Oke
iya, Pak.
okay, ya, oke. Okay. Then kita lihat number two. Students are investigating the cooling of hot water is in a beaker. Yeah, they are using apparatus shown in figure 2.1. Oh yeah, okay. This is thermometer, speaker. Yeah, ini statif ya, yeah, bench. Record the temperature theta R shown the thermometer figure 2.1. Nah, ini kan around 20 lebih ya, Bapak zoom. Ini kan 20 in here. Berarti ini 21 ya yeah, 21 degree ya yeah, di sini so here is 21 degree Celsius ya yeah, 21 degree okay, continue. A volume of 150 centimeter cubic of hot water is put in the beaker and initial temperature theta is recorded in table 2.1. Okay. The temperature of water is recorded by every 30 seconds. The values are shown in table 2.1. Complete the heating in the table 2.1. Okay, this is around 30 seconds, yeah. So here is in second. Aduh, kok kecil. Yeah, in second. In second, and then temperature is in Celsius, ya, yeah, degree Celsius. This is in Celsius. This is S or second, ya, yeah, sec. Yeah. That's it. Complete the heating in table 2.1, yeah, the heating is one. And then describe one precaution that you will take ensure that temperature reading in experiment are accurate as possible. We see this, yeah, this is around after 30. We can see this like change in temperature like constant, yeah. Coba kita cek change in temperature. For example, this is 89 minus 6, yeah, this is also -6, this is also around 4, yeah, this is 4, this is 4, oh, 3 2 2 2, oh. This is like a change in temperature near constant, ya. Yeah. Or ya, yeah, decreases, ya. Yeah. Decreases. But not significant. Yeah. Around, nah, ini kalau tadi around, yeah, 6 2 2, ya, yeah, degree Celsius. Change in temperature near constant, hampir constant, ya, tapi dia decrease but not significant around 6 to 2 degrees Celsius. When we see this is around 6, but when we see this is around 1, ya, yeah. Actually maybe not close, ya, yeah. Kenapa?
Ya, itu itu tanyanya kan gimana kayak biar biar kita recordnya sama kan, recordnya bener banget. Record precaution, jadi apa yang bisa dilakuin biar nanti akurasi itunya lebih akurat.
Oh ya ampun, ya. Berarti tekniknya ini, nah, this one, ini, oh ya Tuhan, ini kalau ini ya, oke, okay. Oh ya, precaution that you would ensure temperature reading and assessment as accurate as possible, ya, oh, oke, start ganti, gini. Itu the first one, ya, yang pertama itu adalah put heat of thermometer in a center of can say this is Center of Hot Water, ya. Center of Hot Water. And nah ini reading temperature in itu apa perpendicular ya side ya or kita sebut itu adalah apa namanya right angle ya. Jadi pengukuran penaruhan temperatur itu harus tepat di pusat di center hot water ya. And reading scale of temperature reading scale of temperature ya in perpendicular side ya di apa tadi kalau kita lihat itu harus tegak lurus. Seperti ini yang mungkin ya karena describe one oh one tapi ini bapak tulis di tadi either ini ataupun ini ensure the temperature reading is accurate as possible ya. Oke seperti itu Kalista ya oke lanjut. Oh, ini tentang temperatur ya. Tadi Bapak lihat hanya sekilas. Ini tentang rasio temperatur. Calculate the average cooling rate X1 during the first 9 second ya. 90 second ya of the experiment. Use the reading from table 2.1 and equation. Where T equals to 90 second theta O and theta T are temperature T O and T 90 second include the unit of cooling rate. Udah kita hitung aja ini X1 berarti X1 ya berarti equals to theta ya theta when 0 serbalik lagi 0 berarti 95 and 90 79 95 79 oke okay. And divided by t is 90 ya yeah, 90 yeah. So equals to 9579 95 kurang 9 sama dengan dibagi 90 ya yeah, this is around 1.77 yes
aku mau restart meetnya bentar soalnya koneksi aku bikin aku nggak bisa lihat.
Oh ya ampun, jadi
ya aku mau restart bentar.
Oh ya oke. Saya tunggu Bapak juga mau ambil air minum. Ya oke boleh.
Oke.
Ya.
I want to take a charger. The video is on or not? Yeah.
Kalau kameranya mati boleh gak?
Oh boleh nggak apa-apa biar ini biar fokus aja nggak apa-apa. Yang
Ya.
penting ini
Ya.
screen Bapak kelihatan oleh Kalista.
Ya.
Ya. Bapak juga screennya matiin aja nggak apa-apa ya.
Oke.
Ya. Oke. Lebih ini. Udah bisa dilanjut atau tunggu dulu?
Boleh
Oke.
lanjut.
Oke. Tadi tuh 0.17 atau round 0.18 ya. Nah, kita tulis this is 0.18. Okay, then I calculate the average cooling X2 during the middle 90 seconds of the experiment. Use reading table 2.1 yeah, and equation X2 is theta 90 and 180 over T. 20 is 90 seconds. Okay, same thing with this one. I will put this yeah, but different number. X2 okay when 90 and 180 ya 90 180 79 79 685 79 79 berapa tadi ya 180 68.5 ya divided by oke okay, T same thing ya 90 second so in here is 79 minus 98.5 yes divided by 90 equals to 0.11666 or let's say this is 0.17 yeah so here is yeah 0 oh sorry 0.12 yeah maksudnya ini adalah 0.11666 1 2 ya yeah. So here 0 1 2 okay that's it again X3 ya yeah. X3 the ya yeah.
Aku sedikit bingung itu itu kayak 79 sama 59-nya dari mana?
Ini yang mana?
Iya, kayak 95-nya gitu-gitu dari mana?
Dari sini, Kalista, dia kan gini, theta 0 and theta 90 are temperature at T0 and T90. Ya, kalau ini theta 0 minus theta 90, this is same thing with theta when 0 is 95, theta 90 is 79. Nah, ini kan 95 tuh, 95, 79. And then T, same thing, T is 90 second. Ya, yeah, 90 second same thing with apa pengurangan ini, 90 kurang 0. Ngerti nggak?
Oh,
iya.
Yeah. Oke. Okay.
Nah, ngerti ya? Jadi ketika 0 second ini berapa degree Celsius? 95 degree Celsius. Ketika 90 second adalah 79 degree Celsius. Dan T ini adalah ini 90 minus 0. Ya, yeah, 90 minus 0 equals to 90. Oke, okay, ser contohkan yang X3 ini. X3 ya. Yeah, X3 itu adalah theta when 180 is 168.5 Sir, ganti ini 68.5. 68.5. Nah, ini tadi copy paste ya. Nah, ini kemudian theta when 270 itu adalah 62.5. Kita ganti ini 62.5. And then T still same thing. T adalah ini 270 minus 180. Ya, yeah, same thing with 90, sama dengan 90. Nah, ini berapa? Ini copy paste yang tadi ya. Ini kita delete. Nah, kita kalkulatorin 68.5 minus 62.5, yes, divided by 90, 0.06666, yeah. Yeah, this is around 0.07, yeah, karena pembulatan, yeah. So here is 0.07, that's it. Okay, then the temperature of water falls as time passes. Temperatur turun ya seiring penambahan waktu. Coba kita cek. Iya betul ya, turun seiring penambahan waktu. Balik lagi. Use result from C ya to describe the pattern of rate of cooling that water during the experiment. Justify your answer by reference to the result. Ini 18 6 12 kurang 7 5. Ya, maybe gini nanti ya. Kalau kita lihat X1, X2, and X3 ya. When we see ya X1, X2, and X3 ya. Ya, they have 0.18 and then 0.12 and then 0.07, yeah. They have like apa namanya decreases number around. Ini kan berkurang. This is 6 and this is 5, yeah. Dia penurunan apa tersebut ya? They have degradatif ya. In decreasing rasio temperatur. Dia memiliki degradasi penurunan dari rasio temperatur ya. Ini kalau kita lihat ini kan seolah kita bisa mengestimate after ini adalah berapa. Kalau ini 0.08, ini 0.12, and ini 0.7, ya berarti berikutnya 0.2 ya. 0.2. So, the temperature of water falls as time passes. Use the result from C to describe pattern the rate of cooling of water during experiment. Just by answer. Ya. Nanti patternnya berarti dia patternnya ini ya, ya ini udah pattern ini ya, yang they have kayak pengurangannya itu around 0.06 and then 0.05 and then 0.04, berarti nanti after 0.07 they have 0.02 ya, dikurang 5 ya. Ini kan dikurang sorry, ini dikurang 5 berarti ini dikurang 4, 0.03 ya. bisa ditangkap nggak kira-kira Kalista? Ngerti nggak maksud Bapak?
Iya, ngerti.
Ngerti ya? Dia kan tanya tentang pattern ya, polanya seperti apa? Polanya menurun dia ya. Kalau Bapak sebutnya adalah degradatif in decreasing, ya penurunan apa degradasi dalam penurunan, ya, gitu. Bukan degradasi dalam kenaikan, tapi dia penurunan. Tapi ini dalam rasio temperatur, ya, gitu. Ya. Karena dia bilang from result C describe pattern of rate cooling water during the experiment. Justify your answer from result. Ya ini nanti ya patternnya seperti ini dia. Gitu. Okay. Give an estimate the probably final temperature theta F of water if left cool for many hours. Wow. Theta F. Okay, Bapak ke atas dulu. Kita lihat theta F. I think gini, ya ini kan dia akan merujuk pada satu yang konstan, Kalista. Kalista lihat 68, 68.5, 69, 64, 62.5. Berarti nanti kalau kita degradasinya bisa jadi ini after ini adalah 61. Ya, ya, terakhir kisaran around 60. Ya, karena dia kayak 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 constant ini ya, 95, 89, 83, 79. Jadi kayak merujuk pada satu nilai yang constant. Ya. Jadi kalau finalnya ya, dia kan suruh decide ya, estimate ya, estimate kalau kita bisa estimate ini adalah sekitar 60 ya, 60 degree. Oh, aduh, kok hilang? Oh my god. Ah, sorry Kalista, itunya presentingnya hilang. Sebentar Bapak buka lagi.
Iya, dok.
Oh my god. Ah ya, this one. Okay. Ah, this one. Okay. Kalista bisa kelihatan ini?
Ya bisa.
Bisa ya? Oke, okay. Ya. Tadi yang ini ya, jadi kalau Bapak balik lagi, ya, ini, gini, cerita yang ini, ya, ini degradatifnya akan merujuk nilai yang perubahannya, ya, decrease-nya itu merujuk pada semakin kecil, ini kan 71,568 berarti round 2, ini round 1,5. Iya. Ini round 2 ya. Ini round 1,5. Berarti nanti kemungkinan di akhir itu ya, kalau kita estimasi itu nilainya sekitar 60-an ya. This is around 60 degree. 60 degree. Seperti itu. Kira-kira bisa dipahami nggak, Kalista? Nah, kita itu dia kan mintanya estimate aja ya, 63 degree Celsius ya. for many hours. Dia nggak mungkin lari ke 50 ini. Kalau kita lihat gini, ini nggak mungkin lari ke 50 ini. Ya, let's say ya bu, kalau six nggak 60 ya 58 ya. Nah, 58 dia apa rentangnya semakin jadi perubahannya itu semakin mengecil. Ya, kalau aduh. Kalau yang pertama itu they have changed around 6, kemudian change around 5, change around 4, change around 3, change around 2, change around 1. Nah, kemudian kan change around a half gitu, change around 0.25, berarti nanti change-nya sekitar-sekitar itu, maka dia akan merujuk pada suatu constant apa degree Celsius, tapi around ini sedikit ke bawah. Ya, berarti ya around 60 degree ya. Oke, kita lanjutkan ya, Kalista ya. Nah, ini a student in another school carries out similar experiment. She start with the hot water in a lower initial temperature. Suggest how her cooling rate are likely to compare those calculated in C. Use the result to expand your answer. Dia mulai dengan hot water at a lower initial temperature. Oh, oke. Okay. Suggest how her cooling rate like. Suggestnya adalah ini sebenarnya. Ini taking time itu jangan di rentang 0 until 30 ya. Karena dia lebih kecil dari lower than ini, maka kita sebut ini temperature water recorded not every in 30 second ya. Jadi nanti bisa kita gini. Misalkan kita copy paste ya. Nah, ini bisa dijadikan suggestnya ya. Bukan every, tapi ini adalah kurang dari gitu ya. Kurang dari 30 second ya. Let's say misalkan 20 second ya. Misalkan langsung aja kita misalkan in 10 second aja. 10 second. Itu akan lebih ini. Why? Because ini ya. She start with the hot water at the lower initial temperature. Kalau tadi kan bukan in lower ya, karena 95 degree itu cukup besar. Ya, gitu. Oke, okay. Suggestnya adalah seperti itu. Ya. Then mungkin suggest yang lainnya adalah maybe ini nah ini nih comparing about rate temperature not in first 90 second ya yeah. Comparing rate of temperature ya yeah. Rate of temperature not in 90 second ya yeah. Ya yeah. Maybe ya yeah. Bisa sebut kita adalah maybe in 30 second ya yeah. Nah, why? Nah, ini explanation-nya. Ini explanation yang pertama, temperatur ya ini because starting temperature ya yeah. Starting temperature in the lower initial ya yeah. Starting temperature in lower degree ya yeah. lebih rendah ya. Kalau kita sebut tadi ini. Sorry, Bapak naik lagi dulu ke atas. Nah. Maaf, maaf, sorry. Nah. Tadi yang stud. Oh, ini. Lower initial temperature ya. In a lower initial temperature. Ya, penjelasannya balik lagi ke situ. Supaya ini sebenarnya rasio ya, or gradient ya, rate in a constant. Bapak sebutkan gini asumsinya ya, kalau biar mengerti. Kayak angka gini, manipulasi matematika ya, seperti kalau di dalam high initial temperature, sebutlah adalah 6 per 10 ya. Tapi kalau di lower itu sama dengan 3 per 5 gitu, rate-nya sama ya, apa rasionya sama ya. Kalau di high temperature bisa kita inisialkan matematik bahwa 6 per sig per 10. Ini kan same thing ya. Same thing with 3 over 5. Nah, ini yang kita sebutkan. Kalau kalau di percobaan yang pertama, in first experiment, ya they have apa namanya? Rentang yang lebih besar ya, bandwidth yang lebih besar. Tapi kemudian rasionya sama aja, gradiennya sama aja. Di eksperimen yang kedua, other student, they have starting for lower temperature, ya lower initial temperature. Tapi kalau kita lihat rasionya, ya same thing ini, kita pakai 3 per 5, seperti itu. Maka different, kalau yang atas gunakan in 30 second, ya in 30 second, ya in 30 second. But suggest untuk eksperimen yang kedua adalah in 10 second ya. Kemudian comparing rate-nya itu adalah in 30 second ya. Kalau T-nya yang ini kan they use as 90 second. Nah, di other student ya, in another school, kita gunakan in 30 second, sepertiganya gitu. Jadi mungkin bisa kita sebut kalau sepertiganya ini tiga kalinya ya. Ini bisa kita 9, ini adalah per 15. Nah, ini kan sepertiganya berarti 3 per 5 ya. Ya, analogi matematikanya seperti itu ya. Nah, ini juga sama ya. Ini ya apa ya? Kita sebut ya, ini sebenarnya yang alasan ini yang kedua, rasio or gradient rate in a constant ya, semua gradiennya sama aja ya, 9 per 15 equals to 3 over 5 ya. Itu penjelasannya kayak gitu ya, mudah-mudahan bisa dimengerti ya Kalista ya, mudah-mudahan
ya.
Oke, sekarang state one variable other than initial temperature which the student should control. Other than initial temperature, time dong tadi. Apa ya dia? State one variable other than ini time. Ya, kita sebut time di sini adalah time recorded ya, time recorded. Ya. Selain itu kan memang time recorded. Time recorded. Apalagi ya, itu mungkin karena emang ini kan kita bicara time recorded sama temperatur. Ah, seperti itu. Ya, time recorded. Oke, Kalista ya, mudah-mudahan bisa dimengerti ya. Ya. Kita continue next.
Ya. Ya.
Oke. Number three, okay, tentang electricity. A student is investigating a power supply using circuit shown in figure 3.1. Okay. Power supply, this is resistor. Yeah, this is P and Q, point when voltmeter is apa namanya? Hold in ya. Dan this is ammeter, this is crocodile. Nah, ini adalah wire ini yang akan dihitung resistance-nya, berapa resistance wire. Okay. The student connect the crocodile claw into a length 100 cm of resistance wire and measure the potential difference VO across terminal P and Q. The current IO in the circuit. Oh, kita baca aja ini ya. Ini kan ini 2.3 berarti ini 2.1. VO is 2.1. 2.1 volt, ya. And then ammeter because this is 0.4, this is 0.2, 0.3. Oh, ini 1. Itu adalah 2. Jadi 22 24 26. Yes. 26 0.26 ya, amper ya. Oke. Maybe this is 2.10 ya, biar dua angka di belakang desimal karena kita akan cari berapa RO nya. RO berarti ya equals to kita bagi aja between 2.0 ya. This is same thing with 2.10 divided by 0.26. This is around 2.1 divided by 0.26. 8.08. Yeah, let's say 8.1 maybe, yeah, 8.1 ohms, yeah, 8.1 ohms, yeah, that's it. Okay, continue ya Kalista ya. B, okay, B. The student then connect to crocodile clips to length 70 cm, 60 cm, 50 cm, 40 cm. 40 cm and 30.0 cm of resistant wire. See, measure the current I in the circuit for each length. Here readings are on table 3.1. Okay. This is when 7, yeah, and they have current. Oh, ini one point I ya, one point I. Coba ini itu 2.1. Iya betul, 1 divided 0.5. Yeah, this is 2.5. Yes, correct. Ini berarti di sini 1 divided by 0.35. Yeah. 2.87. 2.87. This is actually 1 over I ya, 1 over I, 1 over 0.35, 2.87, 1 over 0.4, 2.50, 1 over 0.44, 2.27 ya, yeah, and so on. Okay, calculate and record table 1 for length 70, dan ini, ya, yeah, this one. Okay. Then C, yeah, plot a graph L x L centimeter axis against, yeah, you don't need to start your axis and the origin OO. Okay. This y axis is length, yeah. So we can put here L ya, length in centimeter on the Y ya, and axis is 1 over here, 1 over I. One, two, three, four, five. Yeah, okay. I use this as the origin, yeah, or zero. Yeah. And I'll put here, this is 20. Yeah. This is 40 centimeter. Here is 60. Centimeter, here is 80 centimeter, and here is 100 centimeter. Yeah, because you see this is around 30 until 70. Yeah, okay, yeah, okay. Now I use holder in X direction. Because we start from 1 until 2 ya. Kita lihat 1 2 3 4 5 6 7. 1 2 3. Oh. Oke, okay, I use this is 0.1, 0.5. 0.5 ya. And here is 1.0. Here is 1.5. Yeah. Here is 2.0. Yeah. Here is 2.5. Yeah. And here is 3.0. 3.0. Yeah, maybe here is 3.5 ya. Yeah. Yeah, ini 3.5. Tapi kayaknya kita nggak gunakan ya. Okay, we have around 5 plot ya. Yeah. 70 is 2.87. 70 is in here. 70 is ya, yeah, here 70. 2,87. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yep. Satu, dua, tiga, empat, lima. Ah, this. Ini adalah around 2,87. 2,87. This is 2,85. Wait, 2,87 ya. Ya, maybe around here. Ah, sir, kasih silang aja deh. Estimate aja nih ya, estimate 2,87. And then second one 62,5. 2,5. Oke, 62,5. 60 in here. Oke. Okay. Then 2,27 adalah 50. Dua koma dua tujuh, think around this, yep. Nah. And then 1,89, 1,89, around 2 ya, ketika berapa dia? Ketika 40. And then 1,5430. 1,54. Ya. Yeah. Maybe like this one ya. Yeah. Ini kurang plotnya kurang tepat juga. Nah, kalau pakai kertas maybe Kalista lebih pas ya. Yeah. Jadi kalau kita gambarkan base fitnya garisnya kurang lebih seperti itu. Maybe like this. Yeah. Kalau kita teruskan ya seperti ini, and then ya yeah, tidak harus sampai ke titik origin ya. Ya yeah, maybe seperti itu. Plot graph else in yes, you don't need to start access on the origin. Tidak perlu dari origin, berarti dari sini aja. Yes, from start to finish.
Pak,
ya.
Masih yang tadi aku masih kurang ngerti yang 3B.
3B.
Itu gimana?
Oh, ini this is only this is the data. Yeah. This is the data from the experiment, from this experiment, yeah, the data from this experiment. Actually, data when 70 centimeter, yeah, the current is 0.35, yeah. When 60 centimeter, the current is 0.4. When 60 centimeter, the current is 0.44. 40 0.53, 30 0.65. Nah, after that they need to change ya, yeah, on this apa namanya, on this row they need to change in 1/i, this 1/i 1/35, yeah, this is equal 0.28, yeah, 0.87, sorry. And then 1/0.4 equals to 2.5, and 1/0.44 equals to 2.27, 1/0.53 equals to 1.989, 1/0.65 equals to 1.57. And then on this B, yeah, calculate and record table 3.1 the value of 1/i for length 70 cm. Here, tadinya kan ini kan belum ada, ya. Yeah, this is still blank. Ya, yeah, actually this is only 1/i, 1/35. This is equals to this one. This actually tadi ya, same thing with 1 divided by 0.35, yeah, this, okay, that's it. Then after that we plot, yeah, we plot. This is x y s. This is for y, yeah, y axis, and this is for x axis, yeah. This is y axis, yeah. This is y axis, and here is x axis, yeah. This one, x axis, and we plot it, yeah. We plot it into this, yeah. I use scale for y. L, this is kan around 30 to 70. Ya, yeah, I use around ini ya. Yeah, 0 to 100 ya. Yeah, ini kan coverage, jadi tercover ya, yeah, nilai ini tercover ya. Yeah, cover. And then this is also they around 2 point ini until 1.5. I think this is start from 0 to 3, yeah, around 3. Yeah, this one. Now after we plot it, yeah, this 72.87, ini 62.5 here, yeah, and then 52.27 here, and then 41.89 here, and then 31.54 here. Nah, kemudian kita ambil base width graph-nya aja, ya. Ya, kurang lebih yang mewakili adalah seperti ini. Kira-kira yang berdekatan. Nah, that's it. Yeah. Then he said, "You don't need to start your axis at the origin." Tidak perlu dari origin ya, 0, 0, ya. Karena ini startnya from not from 0, ya. Nah, that's it. Kira-kira paham nggak, Kalista? Oke ya, Pak. Nah. Boleh lanjut apa mau ditunggu dulu?
Lanjut aja, Pak.
Lanjut, oke ya. Nah. Kita lihat di. Oke. Bapak akan zoom. Ya. Di question determine the gradient graph. So clearly graph how you obtain the necessary information. So clearly on the graph how you obtain the okay gini bapak kesini dulu kita akan membuat gradient mencari gradiennya dari segitiga aja ini kalau bapak bikin segitiganya nah kurang lebih mungkin seperti ini. Nah, ini bisa gradiennya kan bisa. Nah, gitu. On the y ya, kalau Bapak coret-coret sini. Nah, ini y1 minus y2. Ya. Ini kan semacam yang this one y itu berarti 70 minus 30. Ini 70 minus 30 ya yeah. This and then on the x direction ya yeah. Bapak change saja warnanya jadi merah kata enggak oh sorry kata gitu ya ini yang y ya. And then yang x ya. Yeah. X ini same thing with ini 2.87 yeah. Jadi 2.87 2.87 minus 1.54 yeah. This is actually for y ini ya. Nah, sini aja deh. Oh, sorry. We will use this value or this number to find the gradient. Ya. Yeah. Because gradient is delta y over delta x. Ya. Yeah. Oke, okay. Here g is gradient is G is on the y is 70 minus 30 and then on the x is 2.87 yeah minus 1.54 so G equals to ini adalah 40 ya yeah, divided by sebentar 2,87 minus 1,4 1,33, 1.33, and then berarti 3 equals to 40 divided by round 30 ternyata. Ya, round 30, ya 30 saja. Ini adalah 30. Ya. Oke, okay, that's it. Oke. Okay. Then from this, calculate the electromotive force EMF E, the power supply, use value of RO from A yang tadi above itu, the equation E GRO plus divided K, K is 100 cm. Oh yes, correct. Okay, I use this E equals to we have G is around 30, yeah, times RO. I back again, RO is in here, this one 8.08, yeah, or let's say 8.1, yeah, okay, back again 8.1, yeah, divided by K, yeah, K is 100, yeah, divided by 100. So we have 30 times 8.1, yeah, divided by 100, 2,43, 2.43, yeah, this is in volt, yeah, yes, this is electromotive force or voltage actually, yeah, this is 2.43 volt. That's it. Then, okay, the ammeter is in the circuit has small resistance, which affect the current. Yeah. The effect of this resistance on the measured current I will be different for each measured length L of the resistance wire. Yes, correct. Then state and explain which length L will be most affected by resistance of the ammeter. Which length L will be this? Yes, correct, yeah. Yes. Correct. Why? Because when the wire, we can say resistance, yeah, resistance, yeah, depends by length of wire, yeah, length of wire. When apa namanya ya, long wire has big resistance, ya, yeah, or small resistance in apa namanya short wire, ya, yeah. Kita bisa sebut bahwa short wire, ya, yeah, yang pendek, ya, yeah, itu adalah apa namanya small resistance, resistance-nya kecil. And long wire, yeah, this is, yeah, big resistance, yeah. And then when small resistance, it means, yeah, yeah, we can say this is high resistance, yeah, increases in ammeter is apa namanya, pembacaannya besar, ya, have apa pas sebenarnya kita ammeter reading high value, ya, ammeter reading high, ya, And then long wire is big resistant ya. Mungkin bukan big resistant, apa yang namanya ya, high resistance ya. Long wire high resistance. And then ammeter reading low. Mungkin bisa Bapak jelaskan gini, kalau semakin resisten itu tergantung depends by length of wire. Kalau short wire, short resistant berarti small resistant. Short wire berarti resistennya adalah kecil. And then ammeter reading high. Karena resistennya kecil. And then long wire high resistance and ammeter reading low. Karena resistennya besar, maka ampernya juga akan kecil ya, seperti itu. Mudah-mudahan bisa dipahami ya Kalista ya.
Iya, Pak.
Oke, ya. Aduh, kita masih ada 4 lagi. Mungkin nanti kita ini, oh, kayaknya sebentar ya. Kita waktunya hampir habis. Oke, nanti ini dijelaskan oleh Andi, ini lanjut ini Kalista aja ya. Kalau ini kan dia wait. A student investigate a wind turbine with an electric generator driven by propeller blade. Yes, okay. Plan an experiment which will enable him investigate how the current resistance connected across terminal turbine varies. Okay, the apparatus. Okay, the model wind turbine. Yes, electrical fan provide moving air turbine. The device must. Okay, in your plan, your salt. Okay. This actually ini ada electric fan ya. Kemudian ada blade memutar, ini kayak pembangkit listrik tenaga angin ya, seperti di Belanda itu. Maka di sini ada turbin ya. Turbin ini change from mechanical energy into electrical energy ya. Dan ini resistor nanti maybe for the load ya, untuk mengecek benar gak ada aliran listriknya. Okay, in your plan you should list an additional apparatus need. Okay, complete the wind turbine circuit. Yes, diagram for one. State the key variable to be kept constant. Explain briefly how carry experiment speed airflow to change experiment. Okay, actually electric fan used for propeller blade to circle atau apa namanya to rotate ya. After the rotate it will be make use coils ya, coils change ya from mechanical energy to electrical energy. Nah, maybe ini kalau kita lanjutkan ini ya. Seperti ini mungkin ya, tapi sebentar. Bentar, jangan deh. Ini jadi konslet dong nanti. Complete the wind turbine. Nah, ya, static keep double keep constant. Nah, kalau keep constantnya mungkin ini ya. Angular speed ya, kecepatan putar namanya angular speed, or circular speed ya, angular speed. And then constant explain dari keras. Tadi yang Bapak bilang ini adalah change from mechanical energy into electrical energy by what? By this one. This is on this turbine they have coils ya, some coils. coil change from we can say this is electromagnetic induction. Yeah, electromagnetic induction. This from this electromagnetic induction forward for change from mechanical energy into electrical energy. So in here they have electrical energy, yeah, the here electrical energy. Before-nya adalah they have mechanical energy on the wind, yeah. Mechanical energy. Yeah, by this, by electric fan, yeah, and then change to from mechanical energy to electrical energy using electromagnetic induction by what? By coils, yeah, coils and magnet, yeah. Here, they consist of two, and magnet. Coils and magnet, yeah. In here, yeah. Okay. Yeah, maybe seperti itu dulu ya Kalista. Sudah 9:33. Kita harus cukupkan sampai sini. Ini kurang lebih
yeah.
seperti itu. Nanti kita lanjutkan besok ya, jam 3
yeah.
ya. Ya. Yeah. Oke, Kalista, terima kasih ya. Sampai ketemu
yeah.
besok. Bye bye.